These films are revolutionary when it comes to strong women in the 21st century.
What the fuck was that?
I don't know, but I liked it.
Welcome to Movie Reviews, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 films with strong female roles. For this list, we're looking at films that have found a way to incorporate feminism, although often declared a dead or dying movement. Until she's better than even you. While still reaching a general target audience.
Are you ready?
Number 10, The Hunger Games.
I volunteer as tribute.
Katniss Everdeen is one of the most fierce archers in the media industry. However, that is not the only reason why Katniss Everdeen from The Hunger Games is on this list. As she fights to the death, Katniss learns the value of feminine strengths and eventually embraces them.
It's okay. You're okay.
Katniss's reaction to Rue's death can be portrayed as Katniss's first act of rebellion. This is because in the arena, there wasn't much time to mourn the dead.
It's fine.
This reasoning is why The Girl on Fire earned her spot at number 10. Number 9,
Do you
Rosie.
Wanna build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play.
Anna goes on a quest to find her sister Elsa for the majority of the film, and learns to become not only independent, but adventurous and brave as well. Elsa, on the other hand, learns independence and in addition becomes the powerful Snow Queen of Arendelle.
I like the open gates.
We are never closing them again.
Furthermore, Disney's Frozen refuses to submit to the happily ever after heterosexual romance trope. Number 8, Captain Marvel. Captain Marvel plays an empowering female superhero role. Unlike Black Widow, Captain Marvel is not sexualized throughout the film. And to complete the look, there are no men included in her background of the woman she became. Number 7, Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman certainly is a strong story for female superheroes.
Or maybe not.
She was raised by a massive group of Amazonian women. These women are extremely capable and are certainly able to handle themselves. Female Amazonians and Wonder Woman herself certainly reflect the power in women played throughout this film.
It's like we're Number six, Go Bombshell. Speak up for yourself. Just know the entire network is with Roger. No one will believe you. They'll call you a liar.
Bombshell is a film about the Fox News scandal involving the sexual harassment of women.
Oh, and as for your career, you want assignments and airtime? Go ahead. Call the paranoid man who decides your salary a pervert and do that on a fucking anonymous hotline he controls. On a phone he has a contractual right to record. Jesus fucking Christ. Do you think women are idiots? It's like somebody stripped you naked and they want you to walk through this office just to fucking prove it.
In the United States alone, almost every other woman is sexually harassed in the workplace.
Higher. If Roger finds out you came to us, he won't just fire you. He will bang us with a $1 million lawsuit. He will attack you personally.
Based on a true story, women were sexually assaulted by the CEO of Fox News, Roger Ailes.
Gretchen Carlson could kill Fox News. This is a fight for your jobs. If I go, you go.
At first, the women were scared because they were afraid people would think that they're lying, they would fear being fired, and that they wouldn't get another job in the future because of how much Fox really controlled. Once Gretchen came out about Roger Ailes firing her for aging, co-workers soon followed her lead, and the CEO concludingly was fired, and the woman that sued him received a $20 million settlement. Number 5, Moana. Moana is incredibly powerful, and not only does Moana not need a man, she does what men fear to do.
We fish beyond the reef.
No one goes beyond the reef.
Moana's father tells her that she must never leave the reef, as it provides safety for her and everyone in her village.
We have one rule.
An old rule when there were fish.
A rule that keeps us safe.
We see the selfless act made by Moana, as she wants to feed her village no matter what the cost. Moana's bravery is built upon her relationships between her mother and her grandmother.
She loves the sea and her people. She makes her whole family proud.
I am a girl who loves my island and the girl who loves the sea.
Moana is one of two Disney princesses to not have love interest. Her love is for her island and for her people. Moana's relationships with the females in her life break the evil stepmother stereotype.
I am Moana.
I became a sister.
Number 4, Brave. Merida, being the only female child having three brothers, won't let anything get in her way if it means being her own individual.
This whole marriage is what you want. Do you ever bother to ask what I want? No! You walk around telling me what to do, what not to do, trying to make me be like you. Well, I'm not going to be like you.
Merida is determined to obtain the freedom she so dearly deserves. Merida loves to participate in archery competitions. However, her family is strongly against it because she's a girl.
You are a princess, and I expect you to act like one.
This exemplifies cultural disarmament. Cultural disarmament is the normalization for a man to be violent, while women are typically seen as vulnerable. Number 3, Midsummer. Five friends take a trip to Sweden for a festival, Midsummer. Christian treats Dani like garbage and takes her for granted.
Sweden. I had no idea.
Well, what do you mean? Because I told you I wanted to go.
Okay, fine, but I didn't know you were going.
I just decided today. I wasn't keeping it from you.
You already have a ticket.
I'm sorry?
Mark is a friend of Christian's and urinated on a sacred tree, labeling him as the fool.
You pissed on the ancestral tree. The tree said what?
Josh, another friend of Christian's, lets ambition take over his morals by photographing the community's sacred artifacts after being specifically told not to. Therefore, these three men, without a doubt, are a sacrifice for the rituals of Midsummer. Mark was skinned alive for urinating on the sacred tree. Josh, killed by a massive mullet for taking photographs of the sacred artifacts. And Christian, burned alive under Danny's orders, who finally saw through him after being taken advantage and gaslit for so long. Number 2, Kill Bill Volume 1.
It's not my intention to do this in front of you. For that, I'm sorry. But you can take my word for it. Your mother had it coming.
Bill attempts to murder Uma Thurman, the bride, on her wedding day. After waking up from a 4-year coma, she's determined to get revenge on her ex, Bill.
Please stop hitting me.
But in doing so, she plans to kill everyone involved and anyone who may get in her way. Such violence in film has only been portrayed by certain actors, mostly men, like Arnold Schwarzenegger. This film has empowered women of all ages, as not only does the bride violently execute more than 60 men in this film alone, but she ultimately gets revenge on her ex, Bill, hence the title of the movie, Kill Bill.
I don't know.
Number 1, Little Woman. Most of my life
in Europe. Oh, that's capital! Shouldn't use words like that.
Josephine, or Joe, is one of the 4 sisters, all whom, except Joe, want to follow the tradition in this time period. Joe questions tradition and does not want to just sit there and look pretty and marry a man solely for his money.
Like women, they have minds and they have souls as well as just hearts, and they've got ambition and they've got talent as well as just beauty. And I'm so sick of people saying that love is just all a woman is fit for. I'm so sick of it.
She wants to have a job as a writer, and despite being criticized because she does not have the correct ending for her story, for the woman to be married to the man or for the man to be dead, her book ended up being a huge success, and the man who told her she didn't have the correct ending ended up reading it. And better yet, she accomplished this without the guidance of a man telling her that her ending was incorrect.